Microphone number two. Microphone two.
Yeah, point of personal privilege. This is I'm Willie Star Marshall from Utah. Still, if anyone has
order, please. Order. Quiet.
If
microphone two.
If anyone has a banquet ticket for tonight that you will not be attending, I have a list of people who would like to attend but were not able to afford one. So contact me at the Utah table or you'll see me around. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Marshall. Now I'd like to bring up onto the stage Ms. Donna Dunn, running for Congress in the great state of Indiana.
Hello. At 211 degrees, water is hot. At 212 degrees, water boils. Boiling water produces steam. Steam can power a locomotive. One extra degree makes all the difference. We are that extra degree. Hello, everyone. My name is Donna Dunn, and I'm running for U.S. Congress in Indiana's 1st District, better known as the Region. I don't want to talk to you today about what I would do as a Libertarian in Congress. We all want the same thing: minimum government, maximum freedom. I want to discuss how we're going to get there. I didn't get into politics. Politics got into me. It's a fact that the two old parties are not what they say, and people are angry, and rightfully so. The Democrats don't care about free speech any more than the Republicans care about free enterprise. They are both too busy saying that each other's candidate is evil and corrupt. When our country was founded over almost 240 years ago, we took on what was at that time the most powerful country in the world. And we can and we must do it again if we want to take our country back. Revolutions happen because people come together and they act and they do something. A small group of colonists, the Sons of Liberty, came together in secret to start the fire of our revolution. Man. Excuse me. Our revolution is much bigger than the American Revolution. We are in this fight together, and we must face our fears. We must be willing to do whatever it takes to ensure a future for our children and our grandchildren. Each of us can take our own path to get there, as long as we are headed to the same destination. Liberty is the great cause that makes all other causes possible. When politicians no longer control the voters, that is when they are most afraid. Our founding fathers believed that people who govern over us are servants of and accountable to the people. It is the people who control the power, not the politicians or political parties, and it is time that we take that power back. The authority of the people, as conferred by the Constitution, has been ignored long enough. This is why we must come away from this convention united. We won't agree on everything, but we can agree that our candidates, whoever they may be, are better than anything the Republicans or the Democrats can come up with. And I would like to close with my favorite quote from Margaret Mead. Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has. Thank you, and my name is Donna Dunn. I'm running for U.S. Congress, Indiana District 1. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Dunn. I want to ask you guys to do something. It's a little bit unorthodox. Everyone who is here as a delegate or an alternate to this convention, please stand up. Here, Kielski. All right. Everyone who has been to two conventions, please stay standing. Thank you, first-timers. Everyone who has been to three conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to four conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to five national conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to six conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to seven national conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to eight national conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to nine national conventions, please stay standing. Everyone who has been to 10 national conventions, please stay standing. Can we take it to 11? What about 12? Lucky number 13. 14.15, 16, 17, 18. Am I incorrect, but is Gary Johnson the last man standing? No, there's more than one. No, it's you, isn't it? Two. Where are we at now? 18? Let's go to 19. You guys both still standing at 19? I have no idea. How about 20? Are you still with 20? Oh gosh, I can't figure this out anymore, but thank these people who have been with us so long, who have lived to see this day. Thank them. It is their work and dedication that has allowed us to be here today. Microphone number one.
Mr. Chairman, if we have some time...
And then, please identify yourself.
I'm Daniel Hayes, Louisiana. If we have some time, we have someone that's ready to come to the mic.
All right, I'll take care of that. Thank you, Daniel. There's no one else seeking to be recognized. I'd like to invite up to the stage a close personal friend, somebody that I got to know very well when I lived in the state of Colorado and was vice chair of that party. A candidate that I have deep love and respect for. She is running for U.S. Senate in the state of Colorado and is former chair of the Libertarian Party of Colorado. I'd like to welcome to the stage Lily Tang Williams.
Good morning, my fellow libertarian friends. I am a living American dream. I am a oppressed girl from communist China, growing up under Mao's regime. I'm running for U.S. Senate today in Colorado. Where I came from, you don't want to ever go there to live like the way I did. Where government tells you what to eat, how much to eat, what to wear, what is your approved hairstyle? What is the, you know, approved speeches? And what to read? What songs to sing? What kind of dance you should do? And how many people should share one bathroom? And I had to eat trapped rat's meat. I don't know if you have ever tried that, but it's not much meat. I'm here to tell you I fear for big, unlimited government. I fear my children will not have the same opportunities to achieve their American dreams. That's why I'm running for U.S. Senate. I hate to see the country I love becoming more like the country I left. In Colorado, the birthplace of Libertarian Party, this year we have a shot. Michael Bennett is a weak candidate. He voted 92% of time with Obama and his party leadership. He sold himself out to special corporate interests with $7 million from lobbyist bankers in his war chest for re-election campaign. Five Republican candidates on the ballot. Each of them has some serious issues. I am the nominee for Libertarian Party. My story is resonating with Colorado voters. I will be in my first debate next Thursday night to counter-strike four other Republican candidates. My message is universal. My message is freedom, prosperity, and American dream. Who cannot vote for that? I am an entrepreneur. I work at home, running small business, and raise three children. I came to this country without speaking English, like the way I do today. And I only had $100 borrowed in my pocket. I got a big dream. I got a spirit. I got an American heart inside of me beating 28 years ago when I first came to this country I love. So I need your help, my libertarian friends. We got so many libertarian hearts beating here in this room. I need each of you go to my website, lilyforliberty.com. Contribute to my campaign. Let's take it over. Washington, stop the mad government train. Thank you.
Is there anyone seeking to be recognized?
Mr. Chairman.
Is that microphone three?
Yes.
Please identify yourself.
Yeah, Aaron Stark, California. I know I might have asked this earlier today, but once again, people are watching this and they may want to know how to get a hold of the Libertarian Party. And I just didn't write down what you stated before. So could you kindly just say it again?
I'm always happy to help the gentleman from California with his points of information.
Thank you so much, sir.
The Libertarian Party, if you want to find out more about the Libertarian Party, you would visit lp.org or call 1-800-ELECT-US. You can also follow us on Twitter at @LPNational. You can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/libertarians. Is it with an S or without an S? I always forget. Someone will tell me. We are everywhere. Microphone three, go ahead, sir.
Jim Fulmer from Michigan. I do have a brief announcement. For those who choose not to go to the elite presidential banquet this evening. There is the Pavitarian Pizza Banquet will be held in the lobby at 8 o'clock p.m. Bring your pizza money, and we'll discuss how we can reach liberty to average Americans in the working poor.
I'm going to ask the secretary which delegations have not turned in their vote at this time. You ask me? You have points of information for me? Okay. Go ahead. I'm going to talk to the secretary for just 1 minute, but before I do, I'd like to bring someone up on the stage to speak to you for about 5 minutes. If we could put 5 minutes on the clock, please. I want to bring up a man who I first met when I was 12 years old. My father, Frank Sarwak, took me to Maricopa County Libertarian Party meetings when I was just a kid. And I read David Berglund's Libertarianism in One Lesson because it was on my father's bookshelf. And I became a libertarian. I have never been anything else, and I never will be. One of the people who showed me how awesome libertarianism is was a gentleman I first met when I was 12 at a Maricopa County Libertarian Party meeting who's still active today. I'd like to bring to the stage Mr. Ernie Hancock.
This message is for the young people. We were young once. Pal Gamel was a very close friend and cohort with all of our activities and so on for, you know, almost two decades. And I wanted to share something with him. But when he died, I wasn't going to be able to tell him. Give me a second. We fought so hard, as the young people did here, and I just want you to know that we've been dealing with young people from when I was young to now, because I always understood that it was always, always generation next. The next generation, the next innovation, the next technology, the next way to be able to communicate our passion and our philosophy with many people all over the planet from, you know, your bedroom, on your laptop. Heck, before there were laptops. So I wanted to share with the young people, I was inspired by when you had all the people stand up and how many conventions that they had gone to. And I wanted to, and I looked and I'm going, you know, there's well over half of you that weren't here in the early 90s or the 90s and saw what a desolate place libertarianism was in this country. It was a lot of great material, but it wasn't disseminated. We're using fax trees. We're having, you know, meetups where you actually had to meet up and call people to get them to come and know, and the Libertarian Party was the Liberty Nexus. Our first web pages, Liberty Nexus. And the reason was, is whenever you came here, you found all these other great activists from around the country sharing ideas of all the cool things that you could do and change the minds of your friends and your family and your neighbors, your community, and change the culture with freedom. Just by being an example, the tip of the spear of liberty on this planet is in this room and across the country. As young activists, when it came an opportunity, a lot of you probably know that I'm the one that created the Ron Paul Evolution logo. Thank you. But what people didn't understand, they go, Ernie, how did you know? I'm like, how the hell did you not know? How did you not know what a powerful message libertarianism is? As libertarians, we understood this type of message was going to penetrate the psyche of a planet, an entire generation. This is not geographical. This is generational. So when I talk to the young people here, I just want you to be encouraged. We didn't have email accounts in the beginning. We didn't have web pages. There was no Twitter or Facebook. And by the way, there's going to be a new decentralized internet that be a-coming. When that does without censorship, without surveillance, where people are able to express themselves freely, without repercussion, and getting paid for whistleblowing and crypto whatever, it's over, man. It be a-coming. And these young people have grown up with this understanding of full freedom of expression without the control of the lamestream media, the media that's so last century. They don't get it. And we have the biggest arrow in our quiver, bigger than anybody else's, just the truth. I've been to a lot of conventions. We kind of dropped out last few years. We're busy doing, I'm publisher of Freedom's Phoenix, host of Declare Your Independence. We have a lot of things that we do. Pal Gamble and I, over 10 years ago, started Freedom's Phoenix in anticipation of 2016. In 1998, my wife and I got involved when we were pregnant with our fourth child, because we knew how bad things were getting. So what did we do? By the time our kids are our age now, then, late 20s, 28 or so, it's going to be bad. And we're going to have a foundation and be ready. Well, when was that? My children are now 26 to 30. It was always 2016 in our minds. 2016 was when we, by the time we start, I have my 11th grandchild coming. I'm in, man. I am in for the long haul. I got, you know, great grandchildren, great children, because we brought them up for a love of liberty and just being left alone. As a talk show host, they always say, you know, they, who are they, you conspirist? So I go, I'll tell you who they are. Let me tell you how, this is how simple it is. There are those that just want to be left alone, and there are those that just won't leave them alone. Which one are you? As you grow up with these simple bumper sticker understanding, you know, freedom's the answer, what's the freaking question? Freedom good, government bad, 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 bad. Your children, your generation, your communities, they just grow up with the right filter to look at where the BS is coming from. And they always go, isn't he that libertarian, as Dr. Feldman was saying? Yeah, that libertarian that. You'd be a good neighbor, you'd be a good example. And I wanted to tell Pal, I was looking forward to telling him, how inspired I was by this convention, more so than any other that I've been to. The reason was, is at that national debate on C-SPAN, we had such a variety and a beautiful tapestry of representation of the Libertarian Party, regardless of who wins. That tapestry represented so well that for the first time in Arizona history that I can remember, there wasn't a no to vote. And we're famous for no to. So I just wanted to share that with you and let the young people know, no matter what the frustrations are in this election cycle, no matter what you come up against, it's just beginning.
I would like the delegation chairs to line up behind, trying to think of the easiest microphone to line up behind. Microphone one, are you seeking to be recognized right now? Go ahead. I would like to ask microphone one.
I would like to ask the body to consider that the Libertarian Party acquire a mascot. And I would like to propose Dobby from the Harry Potter series. Who in the seventh book says, Dobby has no master. Dobby is a free elf, and Dobby has come to save Harry Potter and his friends.
All right, I need the delegation chairs to line up to prepare to announce their votes for President of the United States. By random order, District of Columbia will be first. I would like them to line up in front of microphone one. DC is first. And then we will move in alphabetical order after DC. Please do that now and be prepared to read off your vote totals for president.
Thank you. Ohio.
Ohio?
Yes.
Connecticut.
D.C. should go first. D.C. is first in Florida. Is that Washington, D.C. or D. followed by E?
It's District of Columbia, I believe.
Florida should go second.
Yeah.
Georgia should be coming.
Yeah, I'm sure Indiana's before Ohio.
I believe Georgia's
right here.
Okay,
why don't
you go there?
You need to ask the chair. Are we doing this in any sort of order?
Yes.
All right, is the D.C. delegation chair at microphone one? The District of Columbia, taxation without representation, the belly of the beast, the spawn of Satan. Hopefully we can find the DC delegation chair and get them to microphone one to read their announcement. He's coming, he's moving. Everyone let him get through. We're gonna get this done.
Sorry, our chair was out getting a beer.
That is perfectly acceptable in the Libertarian Party. Why didn't you get me a beer?
I'm standing in.
All right, microphone one, please identify yourself and read out your vote totals.
I'm John Vaught LaBome, delegate from the District of Columbia, the only jurisdiction in this country that still suffers under the yoke of taxation without representation. The District of Columbia cast three votes for the only LP presidential candidate ever to be followed to the floor by three major networks, CNN, Fox News, and CBS. Three votes for Governor Gary Johnson.
Go ahead, identify yourself and tell me your votes.
Mr. Chair, Charles from Florida. I have Mark Allen Feldman at 4, Gary Johnson at 28, John McAfee at 3, Kevin McCormick at 0, Del Perry at 5, Austin Petersen at 13, no write-ins.
Thank you.
Brett Larson from Georgia, from the home of the original million-plus vote-getter, Mr. John Mons. Thank you very much, John. The great state of Georgia cast our 31 votes as follows. Dr. Mark Feldman, 5. Governor Gary Johnson, 9. Mr. John McAfee, 8. Mr. Darrell Perry, 4. And Mr. Austin Petersen, 5. We have no NOTA votes.
Go ahead.
Aloha! Proudly representing the state of Hawaii, as you can tell. All right, our votes are as follow. Gary Johnson, 4. Austin Petersen, 1. That's it.
Thank you.
Aloha!
Go ahead.
Michael Hautzinger representing the great state of Idaho. In Idaho, we're known for more than our potatoes. We're the gem state because our state is rich with resources, which is probably why the federal government still retains over 60% of our land. We proudly cast our ballot as follows. Austin Petersen, 1. Gary Johnson, and the next president of the United States, 6.
The gentleman from Indiana. Nope, sorry. Yep, Illinois. I have Illinois first.
So do I, but I don't see him.
I'm right here.
Oh,
right.
Mr. Green, please cut in line.
There you go. Thank you. The great state of Illinois, where we send our governors to prison. Yeah. Cast our votes as follows. Darrell Perry, 1. John McAfee, 3. Austin Petersen, 4. And Gary Johnson, 19.
Mr. Hauptman.
Joe Hauptman, chairman of the state of Indiana, who is very proud to have found 34 people willing to not be at the Indianapolis 500 today.
It's not a famous one, is it?
No, just the 100th. Is going to have our gubernatorial candidate, who is hopefully going to get them to let us back in the state after this convention, read our numbers.
Rex Bell from Indiana. There's more than race cars in Indiana. There's more than corn in Indiana. We have zero people voted for NOTA. For Mr. Feldman, one. Daryl Perry, two. John McAfee, four. Austin Petersen, nine. Gary Johnson, 18.
Iowa.
Not Iowa.
Do we have Iowa.
Keith Lauby, State of Iowa Chair. Libertarian Party of Iowa is the party that upholds the state motto. Our liberties we prize and our rights we will maintain. In 2016, we will set up a record number of Libertarian candidates running for office. The beautiful state of Iowa casts the following votes. Mark Feldman, two. Gary Johnson, three. John McAfee, one. Kevin McCormick, one. Austin Petersen, three.
Thank you. Kansas.
Sharon Du Bois from Kansas. The Sunflower State votes for Gary Johnson, two. Austin Petersen, two. Daryl Perry, one.
Thank you. Kentucky.
Dave Capano, Commonwealth of Kentucky. In Kentucky, we have an unbridled spirit and more barrels of bourbon than people. We have our priorities straight. It's my pleasure to announce our votes. Governor Johnson, seven. Mr. McAfee, three. Dr. Mark Allen Feldman, one.
Thank you. Louisiana.
Rufus Craig, Louisiana, the host of the next national convention in the most beautiful city in the world, New Orleans. We hope you all are there. We will be having as our special guest at that convention the next president of the United States. We cast our votes as follows. Governor Johnson, four. Austin Petersen, eight. And none of the above, one.
Maine.
Keith Doran, Libertarian Party of Maine, the land of liberty, lobsters, and all the above when it comes to liberty. We cast our ballots for two Gary, five Petersen.
Maryland.
In Maryland, we are registering libertarians at an incredible rate, and we welcome each and every one of them as we grow. The delegates of the Free State of Maryland cast their votes for Gary Johnson, 10, Dr. Mark Allen Feldman, 4, Daryl Perry, 2, and 2 for Austin Petersen.
The Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
Massachusetts, where the American Revolution began in the battles of Concord, Lexington, and Worcester, where in 1783 we used the glorious American tradition of judicial activism to abolish slavery in our state, proudly cast three votes for John McAfee and eight votes for Gary Johnson.
Michigan.
Mr. Chairman, the great state of Michigan, surrounded by beautiful water, but whose incompetent government has made the city of Flint a national disgrace, and whose Secretary of State, she who will not be named, who prevented us from having a candidate on the ballot in 2012, proudly casts five votes for Mr. McAfee, two for Dr. Feldman, one for Mr. Petersen, one for Mr. Perry, one for NOTA, and 15 votes for Gary Johnson.
Minnesota.
Hello, everybody. I'm Chris Dock from the state of Minnesota. Our license plate says 10,000 lakes, but we really have 10,000 taxes, 10,000 regulations, and 10,000 infringements on our rights. That is changing soon. Thank you. We proudly say two votes for Perry, two for Petersen, and five for Johnson. Thank you.
The state of Mississippi.
Mr. Chairman, the Magnolia State, the great state of Mississippi, birthplace of the blues. Resilient citizens who have recently been tainted by the corruption of both the Republican and Democratic parties of our state. We are proud to host the first Libertarian debate of the 2016 season at the world-class Beauvoir in Biloxi, which you attended. We are proud to bring our 8 delegates to this convention, and we cast our ballots in this manner. 1 for Mr. McAfee, 1 for Mr. Petersen, and 6 for the next president of the United States of America, Gary Johnson.
Missouri.
Mr. Chairman, this is Bill Slance from the state of Missouri, the gateway to the West. Missouri is a show-me state. We brought 24 delegates that wanted to be shown this weekend some real liberty and some real freedom, and I think we got it. We cast our votes in the following. Mark Allen Feldman, 1. Gary Johnson, 7. John McAfee, 1. Kevin McCormick, 1. Daryl Perry, 1. Austin Petersen, 12. Noda, 1.
Mr. Fellows from Montana.
I'm Mike Fellows, Chairman of Montana. I'm also running for the U.S. House of Representatives. Montana has the highest vote totals or percentage for a candidate for a two-person, a three-race at 43% in the history of the LP. We also have the Montana Grizz and the Montana Lady Grizz that are in top 5 of attendance. We also have our Carroll College Fighting Saints that have won back-to-back national championships, which is a better job than Alabama. And of course, so the great Big Sky country of Montana cast his votes as follows. Mark Allen Feldman, 1 vote. Gary Johnson, 1 vote. John McAfee, 2 votes. Daryl Perry, 1 vote. And Austin Petersen, 2 votes for a total of 7 delegates. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Nebraska.
Nebraska, the state with more cattle than people. And as of last Thursday, Nebraska is now the second state with a Libertarian state senator. Nebraska proudly cast 2 votes for Gary Johnson and 6 votes for the next president of the United States, Austin Petersen.
Nevada.
Hi, I'm Brett Pajunas. I'm chairman of the Libertarian Party of Nevada, the great state of Nevada, Silver State, the battle-born state, the freest state in the nation. We have prostitution, gambling. We're all going to make this thing happen all across the country. We proudly place our votes. 1 vote for Noda, 1 vote for Austin Petersen, and 11 votes for the next president of the United States, Governor Gary Johnson.
New Hampshire.
Nice try, Brett. New Hampshire is the freest state in the union. New Hampshire was the last state to elect a Libertarian state representative, and soon we hope to make it again. New Hampshire is the landing zone for the Free State Project, so all of you, if it just gets too bad where you are, come to New Hampshire and live free. New Hampshire's a shall-issue state with no mandatory seatbelt laws, no mandatory helmet laws, no general income tax, no general sales tax, and it never will. Because of the fine activism of libertarians, we're actually working repealing laws. We repealed 1/3 of our homeschool laws. We were the first state to get out of real ID. We repealed laws on small breweries, and we recently passed a 9/11 immunity bill. So if you call 911 because someone's sick, the police won't arrest you for being involved in that activity. That was libertarianism. Our state constitution has 8 articles protecting private property. We have an explicit right to conscience and an explicit right to revolution. Oh, we also have jury nullification and a whole bunch of other stuff. We repealed all our knife carry laws, and Because New Hampshire has the highest per capita of libertarians, we will survive the zombie apocalypse. New Hampshire casts its votes as follows. For Austin Petersen, 1. For Gary Johnson, 1. For John McAfee, 2. And big surprise, for Daryl Perry, 5.
New Jersey.
Hi. Melissa Edgar from New Jersey, and we're sorry. the state where you can't smile in your driver's license photo, but I mean, why would you? The most densely populated state with quite a dense population, the Garden State, but chances are you're not zoned for one. With the worst property tax and possibly some Stockholm syndrome, New Jersey cast their votes as follows. We have 2 for Feldman, we have 9 for Johnson, 5 for McAfee, 2 for Perry, and 3 for Petersen.
New Mexico.
Marty Swinney of the soon-to-be great state of New Mexico, where Gary Johnson made some kind of history. And the birthplace of the atomic bomb. And please excuse me for stepping to the microphone too early. I don't understand alphabetical order. I went to public school. We cast our ballots for 2 for Daryl Perry and, oh God, 11 for Gary Johnson. That's 13. Thank you.
New York.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The great Empire State of New York is the land of taxes and government giveaways, political corruption, and the rising Libertarian Party is proud to announce that we have 0 no to votes, 1 for Dr. Feldman, 3 for John McAfee, 3 for Daryl Perry, 16 for Austin Petersen, and 16 for Gary Johnson. Thank you.
North Carolina.
Barbara Howe, delegation chair from North Carolina. J.J. Summerall is state chair. Come to North Carolina. We assure you we have enough bathrooms for everybody. We proudly cast our votes, 1 for Daryl Perry, 1 for Kevin McCormick, 2 for John McAfee, 3 for Austin Petersen, 4 for Mark Allen Feldman, the anesthesiologist who won't put you to sleep, and hopefully the next president of the United States, Gary Johnson, 18.
North Dakota.
Thank you. North Dakota, the frozen wasteland state, is proud to be down here in sunny Florida for any excuse. And we are also very proud of all our presidential candidates. And I think we've done an amazing job for all of them. We'd like to give them a hand, no matter who's the winner. And we cast the following votes, 1 for Johnson, 2 McAfee, and 2 for Petersen. Thank you.
Ohio.
Ohio. I'm legally obligated to do that. Christopher Gill for the state of Ohio. We are first in flight, home of the Wright brothers, Neil Armstrong, John Glenn, and over 24 other illustrious astronauts. We cast our votes as follows. For John McAfee, 3. For Mark Allen Feldman, 8. For Austin Petersen, 9. For Gary Johnson, 21.
Oklahoma.
Greetings from Oklahoma, a state ranking number 1 in the incarceration of nonviolent women to the rate of 2 times the national average, and answering the question, why aren't there more women in the party with, maybe we have them all locked up. We proudly cast 6 votes reflecting our diversity and independence as follows. 1 for Daryl Perry, 1 for Mark Allen Feldman, 1 for Austin Petersen, and 1 for John McAfee, and 2 for Gary Johnson.
Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania, home to the Liberty Bell.
home to the delegation that is the answer to life, the universe, and everything. We voted proud and loud for Libertarian candidates in 2016, and as we vote to change history, we voted as follows. Gary Johnson, 16. Darrell Perry, 12. Austin Petersen, 6. John McAfee, 4. Mark Allen Feldman, Dr. Rapper Extraordinaire, 3. We had one abstention, and that is all.
Rhode Island.
The biggest little state in the union has a special request for this delegation. When we get home Tuesday morning, we're going to ask everyone to do one thing. Turn off your computer. Take to the streets. Engage the body politic. Make it personal. Teach America about liberty. Move beyond Facebook and Twitter. Get involved in your community. Be the voluntarist that we are. Take it personally. The biggest little state in the union supports Gary Johnson 3-0.0. Thank you.
South Carolina.
South Carolina, the original home of the Gadsden flag and of Francis Marion, who turned the tide toward freedom in that revolution a few hundred years back, proudly cast 4 votes for Mr. Petersen, 9 votes for Mr. Johnson.
South Dakota.
South Dakota delegate, my name is Yvonne Rainey, and I am here to cast the one and only vote representing South Dakota for the one and only Gary Johnson.
Tennessee.
The great state of Tennessee, where we recognize that internet polls don't mean jack shit. We have 0 votes for Noda, 1 vote for Perry, 3 votes for McAfee, and 14 votes for the next president of the United States, Gary Johnson.
Texas.
My name is Kurt Hildebrand, and I am proudly representing 60 delegates from the Free Republic of Texas, which has qualities and blessings more numerous than the stars, which I might add, the stars at night are big and bright. And we cast our votes as follows. Darrell Perry, 2. Mark Feldman, 7. Austin Petersen, 10. John McAfee, 15. And Gary Johnson, 26.
Utah.
I'm Willie Star Marshall. I was elected mayor of Bigwater, Utah in 2001 as the first openly gay mayor in Utah. Utah is the beehive state and the headquarters of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, the Mormons. And at this point, I usually do some stand-up comedy, but today I want to speak to all those across America who are or were Latter-day Saints. Are you tired of voting for the lesser of two evils? Do you believe in the doctrine of free agency? Are you concerned that America is losing its freedom? Do you wonder if the Constitution is hanging as if by a thread? We invite you to look at the Libertarian Party. We are raising the title of liberty. Come join us. www.lp.org or 1-800-ELECT-US. And so, Utah proudly casts its votes as follows. Feldman, 1. Johnson, 2. McAfee, 2. Petersen, 2. And 1 vote for Ron Paul.
Vermont.
Bonnie Scott from the brave little state of Vermont, where the Second Amendment is your gun permit. The delegation from the Green Mountain State casts 3 votes for John McAfee.
Virginia.
I'm Bo Brown, and I'm representing the beautiful and historic Commonwealth of Virginia.
Home to many libertarian legends, including Dr. Jim Lark, Mark Montoni, Bill Redpath, and Robert Sarvis. We are the doorstep to DC, and we are ready to kick that damn door down. We cast our votes as follows. No vote, one. Dr. Mark Feldman, one. Daryl W. Perry, two. John McAfee, two. Austin Petersen, six. And Gary Johnson, 19.
Mr. Brown? Did you say none of the above had won? Or was a no vote? It was an abstention. Thank you. Washington. It was an abstention. Washington.
David Traynor, chairperson, Libertarian Party of Washington. From a state that in 4 short years has gone from zero to fielding 32 candidates this year in 2016.
Mr. Traynor, for the hall, can you tell them where those candidates are standing right now?
There's a good portion right there.
Go ahead, Mr. Traynor.
From a state that is regularly beating the top two primary and has elected 5 libertarians last year alone, the truly ever green state, our vote totals are as follows. Mark Allen Feldman, 1. Austin Petersen, 3. John McAfee, 10. Governor Gary Johnson, 13. Thank you very much.
West Virginia.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My name is John Buckley. I'm the delegation chair for West Virginia in the absence of our esteemed state chair, Michael Wilson, who unfortunately couldn't be here. West Virginia, the mountain state, is a small state with just barely 3 congressional districts. 2 years ago, we had 14 people at our state convention. This year, we had 112. I believe on a proportion basis, we had the largest turnout per congressional district of any state in the country. We have 5 delegate votes, and we cast 5 votes for Austin Petersen.
Wisconsin.
I am Jeff Korch from Wisconsin, the Badger State, where Green Bay Packers is not a football team, but a religion. In 2002, we ran a candidate in the Libertarian Party for governor who ran a supper club, Eb Thompson. He got 10.5% of the vote against the sitting Republican and the sitting Democrat who is the Attorney General. We think we can do better. Wisconsin cast its ballots as follows. Daryl Perry, 1. John McAfee, 2. And for the next president of the United States, Governor Gary Johnson, 13.
Wyoming.
Mr. Chairman, Wyoming cast its votes as follows. Darrell Perry, 1. The next president of the United States, Gary Johnson, 2.
Thank you. Alabama.
Lee Lachine, chair of the Libertarian Party of the great state of Alabama, where our motto is, we dare defend our rights. We are home of atrocious ballot access laws, the world's longest constitution, and of course, college football. We proudly cast our votes. 1 for Austin Petersen, 2 for Daryl Perry, 3 for John McAfee, and 7 for Governor Gary Johnson.
Alaska.
I'm Ron Windler, delegation chairman from Alaska. Alaska, the largest state that is a wholly owned subsidiary of the oil industry, casts our votes as follows. 1 for Mark Allen Feldman and 5 for Austin Petersen.
Arizona.
Good morning. I'm Michael Kilsky, chairman of the Arizona Libertarian Party and a perennial candidate. Arizona has a proud history of producing contrarians. We have such historical figures as Geronimo and Cochise. The Miranda decision came out of Arizona. Barry Goldwater from Arizona. We also have 22 sovereign nations within the borders of the state of Arizona. But they're sovereign in name only. They're run by the BIA. Arizona proudly casts its votes as follows. Although I do have to say I'm embarrassed that this time we only have 0 for NOTA. Austin Petersen, 2. Daryl Perry, 2. Arizona's own Kevin McCormick, 2. Dr. Mark Feldman, 2. John McAfee, 7. Governor Gary Johnson, 11.
Thank you. Arkansas.
Arkansas, the natural state, one of only 2 states in the nation that produces diamonds and that has also produced the gems of Clinton and Huckabee. We're sorry, we have a long way to go. Arkansas cast its votes as follows. None of the above, 1 vote. Mark Allen Feldman, 1 vote. John McAfee, 3 votes. And Gary Johnson, 4 votes.
California.
Yes, fellow libertarians, I'm Ted Brown, chair of the Libertarian Party of California. I want to introduce a couple of people. With me is Jeff Hewitt, the libertarian mayor of Cali Mesa, California, and a candidate for the California State Assembly 42nd District in the upcoming June 7th primary. Also, California has 35 candidates running in an open primary for U.S. Senator, and we have 2 of them who are libertarians, and they're right here, Gail Lightfoot and Mark Matthew Hurd. Yeah. California, the golden state, where the gold was stolen long ago by the socialists of Sacramento, has 115 votes to cast, and they are as diverse as the diversity of our delegation. We cast 1 vote for Vermin Supreme. Yeah. One vote for Heidi Zeman. Heidi Zeman, 1 vote. Kevin McCormick, 3 votes. 4 votes for Daryl Perry. 4 votes for Mark Allen Feldman. 21 votes for John McAfee. 33 votes for Austin Petersen. And 48 votes for the next president of the United States, Governor Gary Johnson. Thank you.
Colorado.
Steve Gallant from the great state of Colorado, home of the ass-kissing Lily Tang Williams. And you can donate to her no matter where you live, so just saying, Lily for Liberty. We cast 1 vote for Mr. John McAfee, 1 vote for write-in Derek Grayson, 2 votes for Mr. Austin Petersen, 2 votes for Mr. Daryl Perry, and 17 votes for Governor Gary Johnson.
Connecticut.
Hello, the great.
You're supposed to drop the mic after you speak.
That's right, I forgot.
Go ahead, Connecticut.
Connecticut, the Constitution state that's forgotten what the Constitution means. Home of Nathan Hale, the Nutmeg State, and state desperately in need of being free from Democrats' control. Proudly cast 4 votes for Austin Petersen, 3 votes for John McAfee, 3 votes for Gary Johnson.
Delaware.
Yes, hello everyone. My name is Scott Gesty. I'm the chair of the Libertarian Party of Delaware, and I'm also the candidate for Congress this year in the state. And I'm proud to represent the first state. Delaware casts its ballots as follows: one for Kevin McCormick, one for Austin Petersen, and one for Gary Johnson.
That concludes the voting for President of the United States. If the Secretary could please display the results on the screen. Switch to video feed 2. Microphone 3.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, could you please...
Order, please. I was in the midst of recognizing microphone number 3. Mr. Starr, go ahead.
Yeah, but sorry, Mr. Chairman, but once again, with everyone paying attention on the television this time, I'm sure a few might be interested in the Libertarian Party.
You know, I understand you might not have written down that last point of information, but
I apologize.
The way to find the Libertarian Party and find out more about us if you are interested in joining a new political home, go to lp.org or call 1-800-ELECT-US. I will read the results of the vote. Mark Allen Feldman with 58 votes, 6.27%. Gary Johnson with 458 votes, 49.514%. John McAfee with 131 votes, 14.162%. Kevin McCormick with 9 votes, 0.9%. Daryl Perry with 63 votes, 6.8%. Austin Petersen with 197 votes, 21.297%. There were 5 votes for Noda and 4 write-ins. With no candidate having achieved a majority on the first ballot, we will proceed to a second ballot. Kevin McCormick will be dropped from this ballot. Noda will be added to this ballot, and we will vote again. Delegation chairs, please approach the Secretary's assistance table. It's going to take 5 minutes, so stand at ease for 5 minutes. It is now 5 minutes until 12. We are scheduled to stop at 12. Who wants to stop and who wants to keep on trucking? Then we will continue. I will have to hand the gavel off at 12:15 so I can attend a press conference. At this point, I would like to invite the candidates from the Libertarian Party of Washington who are running on the ballot as Libertarians onto the stage, and their state chairman, Stephen Neilson.
Thank you, sir. That's former state chairman. I handed off my gavel in April so that I can run for public lands commissioner in the state of Washington. But I'm not running alone. I've got 32 amazing candidates with me, several of them here with me today. In Washington State, the caliber of candidates that we have are so great that the party in name only, the Republicans, are begging us to run as Republican or at least independent Republican. But you know what we are? We are Libertarians. Absolutely. I want to take one moment to thank everybody on this stage and everybody back at home in Washington State who has taken that courageous step to stand up for liberty, raise the torch, scream into the wind that we are Libertarians and we are here to win for you. Yeah. I would like to just hand off the microphone real fast so that all of these amazing candidates can quickly say their name and where they're from, what they're running for, because I believe in making sure that everybody has a voice for liberty. Please.
What a great day to be a libertarian!
Yeah!
I'm Randy McLan, and I'm running for state legislature from Spokane, Washington. Last election, I got 8% of the vote against a Democrat and a Republican. This time, I'm only running against the incumbent Democrat, and I'm going to take that 8% and those disenfranchised voters, and I'm going to go all the way to victory. Thank you.
I'm Tim Turner from Redmond, Washington, raised in Vancouver, Washington. I'm running for Secretary of State in Washington. We have a problem in our country with a broken political party system, and it's time for America to stand up and fix the party system. Thank you.
I'm Paul Attis. I'm running for Lieutenant Governor of Washington State.
Woo!
It is time to get rid of this duopoly that's running our political system. It is time to get the corruption and the big money interest out of politics and let it be liberty and justice for all. So I'm speaking to the people in Washington to vote Libertarian this year for a freer Washington and a freer United States. I ask you to go back to your homes and do the same. Get out there and get the vote out for the Libertarian candidate in your area. If there's not one, get on the ballot if you can, but find one to support. Thank you very much.
My name is Benjamin Junafelps, and I'm running to represent Bellevue, Washington, where I've lived for 20 years in the Washington State House of Representatives. This is our year. This is our moment. We have an unprecedented chance to seize this country in the name of liberty for everyone here, for everyone at home.
My name is Michelle Darnelle. I'm running in the 48th, Bellevue, Redmond, Kirkland, Washington. I ran in 2014 and got 37% of the vote in a swing district. I am now running because I am going to be the first female libertarian elected to a state position in the nation. That is my goal. I've been on track since Ron Paul. And the good news is I just scared a GOP possible out of the water, so I'm on my way to the general. I appreciate your support. I want the whole country talking about my campaign and the campaigns of these fine gentlemen up here. We need to take to the streets. The bell of liberty rang this weekend. Let the vibrations reverberate throughout this country. This is our time. This is our hour. We are patriots of a new age for liberty, love, and logic. Thank you so much. Michelle Darnelle for the House.com.